I'm Christina Pascucci in Lviv, Ukraine.
KTLA's Christina Pascucci, the only local LA television reporter on the ground in Ukraine.
Now rushing down to this makeshift bomb shelter.
They don't want to leave. They want to stay and they want to fight.
This has become the worst humanitarian crisis since World War II in Europe.
Very emotional because, in the grocery stores, the shelves were empty and they had supply chain issues because of the war.
The psychological war is perhaps the greatest to fight.
He became very emotional when he was talking about his neighbor. He doesn't know what's happening with him.
It is dawn on day 21 of war. Even though time feels like it has stopped, life continues. The Russian soldiers, that is, wanting to demoralize and break people, killing now at least three journalists. But today, the fight for freedom continues.
People have been praying and kneeling and crying and finding peace in their faith.
You see kids and their mothers, but their fathers aren't allowed to leave.
No, they're not allowed to leave, so we can't take them on the ambulances or to the border.
Wearing a bulletproof vest, there were reports that Russian spies were arrested here in Lviv as they were trying to mark buildings to be bombed. So there's this very real threat that people are aware of.
We were all kind of looking up at the sky like, could we be bombed?
We're doing everything we can for us to survive because this war is a war of survival.
Getting out was a nightmare.
Our family members in Russia indeed do not believe us that we are shelled now.
We've been talking about the spirit of the Ukrainian people, and this is an example of how they are chipping in to help defend their country. These steel hedgehogs are made by volunteers. The intent is to stop Russian tanks. And that's not all they're doing. Civilians with no military experience are signing up to fight.
Standing at attention. They are a new kind of soldier, Ukrainian men and women training by the thousands to take up arms.
Why are you doing this?
Because I live here, also my family live here. I need to protect my family in case the Russian army comes to Lviv.
This 44-year-old father is a hotel service worker who loves his country.
And, in case that will very hard time here, maybe I will know how to save people's lives.
Andrew's not alone. Training courses like this one, which includes survival skills, have been inundated with days-long waits, and big lines have gathered outside ammo stores daily before they even open. Plus, an interesting new use for breweries. During wartime, the sale of alcohol is banned throughout the country. So one brewery that used to sell beer got creative and decided to join the fight against Russia by making Molotov cocktails instead.
The guys started to produce the cocktails, and I produced. In 3 days, we made more than 2,000. To support the Ukrainian army, to support the defense forces, just to stop this war and stop the deaths of people, of our kids.
Meanwhile, the mayor of Lviv's wife has been working with displaced children and pregnant women in the school she helped build. She likes to refer to them as pilgrims, not refugees. She says Ukrainians are one body, one soul, and she'll support anyone who opts to stay in Lviv, where it's safer than the East, yet still on Ukrainian soil.
We're open to everybody who come here, and everybody can find love and hope and help. Welcome to Lviv.
We're now rushing down to this makeshift bomb shelter because, as I've been talking about, the air raid sirens just went off again. Well, it's hard to encapsulate all that's happened. You saw a lot of it here.
KTLA's Christina Pascucci joins us live from Lviv, Ukraine.
This is such an honor right now to be sitting in the living room with this family.
This war hit really close to home, and I really wanted to help.
I need to protect my family.
Very emotional.
But there's much more you didn't see on TV, like Marine John Barton, who prepped us with gear like a Kevlar bulletproof vest and helmet, a gas mask in case of a chemical attack. We needed this note from the Ukraine government allowing the Children of War Foundation to come. The travel took 30 hours. The border was tense. Guards asked if we knew we were entering a war zone. Our team of 13 was on edge as we crossed into Ukraine by 3 a.m., driving past a long line of fleeing Ukrainians and the very site that had been bombed that day.
Officially, war has arrived in the West.
A lot of people have been asking about where we're staying, what it's like, so I figured I would show you. Welcome to the Children's Hospital.
We got a shower. This is what the room looks like.
These are my girls. That's Kayla. That's Drea.
Drea is a former Marine who came for extra security. This is some of our team that spent the days performing life-saving heart surgeries on children that would have otherwise died.
But at least we've given them a chance.
We'd grab a quick bite at the hospital before 20-hour workdays, often awakened by the air raid sirens. This is our 20-year-old fixer, as we call him, named Markian, or Mark. He helped translate and produce. Sometimes he held my iPhone to shoot my shots as displaced children clung to him, and he made us part of his family, generously inviting us in for dinner. His best friend, displaced from Kyiv, shared this.
Overnight, basically, our lives have changed drastically. Everything has changed, and we are, I would say, very, very angry, and we're ready to fight.
We evacuated in very dramatic fashion last night.
The evacuation happened very fast as tension grew. Our rides to Poland had been canceled. Our team questioned whether we'd be able to get out at all. In the end, a good Samaritan helped us cross the border in the back of his truck.
There was a bombing just hours after we were able to get out, and we ended up staying in this home along the Polish border. We're on a fish farm.
What's wrong with the world, mama? People fight and think the world's gone cold, mama. People dying when alone in their homes, God. And listen, people take their lives as a joke now. And overseas got the bosses doing talks now.
What made it all worth it were the people we met. Despite so much pain and loss, their giving and fighting spirit, their pride, their faith, their steadfastness. Our week in Ukraine served as a reminder the worst of humanity can bring out the best.
People killing, people dying, children hurt, can you hear them crying? Can you practice?
All of this was made possible by the organization we embedded with that we've told you about, the Children of War Foundation, COWF.org, because you guys, they are going back in a couple weeks and the work continues. I mean, this war rages on and it's far from over, as we know.